All right. Sorry about that. Been a little bit. So, where were we going? Why is that still showing our destination? I don't remember pinning that. Interesting. All right, let's move on, I guess. We forgot to change up our party too.
See you around.
Do that. Let's do that right now. Can I not switch them? Whatever. Okay. We'll figure it out after.
Should we be worried about those things?
We're fine.
How can you be so sure?
Because I've read the field guide. Like any good soldier, local wildlife will only attack while on the hunt or in defense of their territory. If they're attacking, what is it meant to be?
Destination thing actually like glitched the thing. Oh, okay. Gotta read it. Definitely going to be a really long game. Especially with all the side stuff we can do.
Thank you.
Can we not do anything with the towers just yet? Not because we actually, I don't know. Okay, we'll come back and figure that out. I'm surprised this isn't enough distance. Second.
Avalanche, folks. It's okay, I'm on your side.
Heard you be heading my way.
You're safe here, but not for long. By the sound of it, Shinra's leaving no stone unturned. Might want to hole up at the old dock out by the swamp. I'd wager Shinra's forgotten it's even there.
Okay, was that what I needed? Yep. Okay, there's got to be a way though to change up my party. So, for that for now. Bill?
My favorite group of hitchhikers.
Oh, fancy meeting you here. Thanks again for the ride to Calm.
Don't mention it. It's the least I could do for two such lovely young ladies. But I do believe I neglected to introduce myself. The name's Bill, and you can count on me for a lift anytime. Except today, that is. Afraid the old butte's pulled up lame. Sorry about that.
No biggie. We're enjoying the fresh air. Thanks, though.
You, know someplace we can hunker down?
Hunker down, you say? Oh? I'd almost forgotten what it was like to be young and in love. Y'all just head straight that way toward the swamplands. You'll find an abandoned building by the dock. I guarantee no one will bother you there.
Bet. Wonder how the towers work. Like these guys.
There. See you around.
Purple. What we got in here? Leak saber. All right.
No sign of Shinra.
Yeah. Looks like an old Republic landing.
Could borrow a boat, make our way across. Then head on through the mines and keep going till we hit Junon.
Sure. Why not?
You'd trust these rotting hulks?
I mean, we could.
Let's not.
Then maybe we swim it.
This swamp is home to the deadly Midgard Sormer. Beware. But even if you're slow, you can rent a chocobo. We'll see you safely past being nothing if not fast. So just give Bill the word, and he'll pick you out. A bird! Well? Can we rent some birds? Can we?
Fine.
Definitely gonna go chocobos right away, then we'll do some exploring around this map before we go to the next. Also, we did pick up that sleek saber, so let's take a look. I should have read what it said. Right. That thing looks pretty cool. That's actually not bad. Actually, I don't think we need to rest right now. We should be all right. Want somebody?
We got this. Come on.
What?
Pleasure to see you all again, and welcome to my humble ranch.
Managed to get your truck fixed?
Indeed I did. You must have been my lucky charms. She started up right after you left. Anywho, what can I do you for? You in the market for some fine feathered friends by any chance?
Are we ever? Need them to get through the swamplands.
Then you have come to the right place. Back in the day, we had Republic ferries to get us from A to B, but now they're nothing but driftwood, sadly. We got the next best thing, though, chocobos. To them, a bottomless bog's no worse than a kiddie pool. Now, ladies, you're probably wondering, what gives these birds the power to glide across swamps with ease? Would you believe that their fluffy feathers give them the buoyancy to float, while their limber legs can outrun a motorboat? Not even the dreaded Midgard Sormer, one of the fastest fiends around, can keep up with them.
Wow.
But you don't need convincing. You just need pointing to a hard-working chocobo, nature's two-legged limousine.
So can we rent some?
Sure can. My grandson Billy's in the stable over yonder. He'll help you out.
Another Billy.
Howdy.
Saw the sign. Need some chocobos to cross the swamp.
Sorry, Pops, but you're out of luck.
Pops?
Got no more birds. Last one went this morning.
Could have fooled me, kid.
These are spoken for. That or they're not fit for riding. But I can see you're in a bind, so I'll bump you up the list. For a price, of course.
Which is?
10 grand each.
The thing is, we don't have that kind of money. Or any, really.
Or.
Well, there is one other option. Only cost you a grand. Is what a scoundrel might say. But I wouldn't dream of distressing y'all further. Just so happens one of our birds ran off the other day. Wild thing, but still a fine chocobo. If you can manage to find and catch him, then he's yours, free of charge.
You sure?
Yeah, why not? Name's Pico, the hardest-headed bird you'll ever meet, by far. And he's the spitting image of Pops here. You can start by looking for his tracks. If Find those, and you're sure to find the feet that made them. Now, wild chocobos can be a bit skittish around people. But if you play it cool and creep up real quiet-like, you'll wrangle them no problem.
I think we can do that. Thanks.
And one last thing. This info comes free of charge, provided you promise to stop by our shop. Speak to Chloe back there. She'll sell you whatever you need.
Kids are born businessmen.
If y'all can catch our runaway and get his butt back here, riding and rearing lessons are on me.
All right, let's go to the shop first before we go on.
Sorry about my brother. All he thinks about is money. He's just doing his job. We understand, I suppose, but he's been a real pain about it ever since our parents left. Say, are you guys from Midgar? Yeah, the Undercity. Then do you happen to know Chocobo Sam? Not very well, but yeah, I guess we do. Where is he?
Probably the Sector 6 slums. He's a big deal in Walt.
Why do you ask? I was thinking about reaching out. It's his fault Mom and Dad are gone, so...
Chloe, that's none of these good folks' business.
But they could help.
Don't tell anyone what she told you. Sam's one of the biggest names in the business. If he gets wind of that story, our ranch is done for.
Don't worry, your secret's safe with us. I promise. Oh, take these greens. You can give them to Pico when you find him. They were always his favorite treat, you see. Maybe he'll come back once he's had a taste. Right. Should probably sell you stuff, huh? Billy will throw a fit if I don't at least try to get you to spend a few gil. No pressure, but if anything catches your eye. Also, if you have any golden plumes on you, I can exchange them for chocobo gear. So be sure to hand them over if you do.
All right. One. Oh no, we have zero. Wait, what?
Some tracks.
I don't remember how to crouch.
Keep it down. When you're on the hunt, you don't want to startle your prey.
Prey? You know we're not here to kill him, right?
Yeah.
I'm gonna move.
Thank you.
What? Golden plums right there. Probably get a piece of gear when we go back.
Aww, isn't he just the cutest? You know, they are kind of similar.
Totally.
What now?
Do you think maybe he's still hungry?
Sorry, that's all the food we had.
But you know where there's more? Bill's place.
Oh. Back to the ranch it is then.
Come on.
Somewhere we can, I guess so. All right, I'm gonna restart this video real quick.